वेलकम क्लास 7। टुडे वी हैव कम टू द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ आवर कंप्यूटर हार्डवेयर चैप्टर। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द इंटरनल हार्डवेयर कंपोनेंट्स। सो फार व्हाट एवर कंपोनेंट्स वी हैव सीन दैट आर कनेक्टेड एक्सटर्नली टू द कंप्यूटर टू सपोर्ट आवर इनपुट एंड आउटपुट ऑपरेशंस। नाउ अलोंग विद दिस वन देयर आर मेनी अदर कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ द कंप्यूटर सिस्टम व्हिच आर लोकेटेड इनसाइड द सीपीयू कैबिनेट और सीपीयू बॉक्स। So these components are mainly used to perform data processing or power management functions. Such components are called internal hardware components. Examples are motherboard, CPU chip, SMPS, RAM, ROM, internal modems, etc. Among these, first we will discuss about the motherboard. The motherboard, which is also known as the main board, is an electronic circuit board which connects all parts of the computer together. The devices like CPU, memory card, hard drives, ports and other expansion cards such as sound card, video card are connected directly or via cable to the motherboard. It is generally located on the backside at the bottom of the CPU box. It allocates power and allows the communication among all the hardware components. So this is the main life of the hardware parts. Next come for the CPU. What we see from the outside, that is the CPU box, that is just a cover made of plastic or tin. So CPU means it's a different types, different parts are there. The CPU is the processing device. It is fixed inside the CPU box. It processes and stores the data and instructions given by us. It controls all input devices and output devices. As you see in the video, there are different parts are there: ALU, CU and the memory unit. ALU or arithmetic logic unit performs all the arithmetic and logical operations such as the addition, subtraction and many more. CU or control unit controls the activities of a computer system. It decodes the instructions, determines the storage area of instructions and data. It takes data to the ALU and from the ALU to the main memory and then to any other output device. Next is the memory unit, very common to us. Memory unit receives data, holds it and delivers it according to the instructions from the control unit. So it performs a very, very important role in smooth functionings of the total computer system. Next come another very important, that is the SMPS or the switched mode power supply. SMPS is an electronic circuit box fixed inside the CPU cabinet which provides all well-regulated power supply to the various parts of the system. Irrespective of the input variations, it takes rectified AC input from the main power and converts it into one or more lower voltage DC output after performing the power factor corrections. It offers a greater power conversion and reduces the overall power loss. The power supplies have high efficiency and provide stable power supply to the sensitive electronic parts of the computer. So, in simple language, SMPS controls the power or the current. Next comes the video card. Video card, also known as the graphic card or the graphics adapter. It's an electronic card that allows the computer to send graphical informations to the display adapter like monitor, projector or TV. This card is directly inserted in the expansion slot on the motherboard. It includes a processing unit, memory, cooling mechanism and connections to a display device. If you want to watch movies or play games on the computer, a dedicated video card improves the quality of graphics up to a great extent. Next comes the sound card. A sound card is also known as the audio card. It's an electronic card that provides input and output of audio signals to and from a computer. Nowadays, these cards are integrated into the motherboard. Unlike the other hardware components, it is not necessary to have a sound card in the system to make a computer work, as they are required only if the computer is to be used for multimedia applications. Next, the internal memory. Very, very important part. Internal memory are of two types. One is the RAM, another one is the ROM. So we already know that It stores data and instructions temporarily, that is the RAM. When you start the computer, the operating system is loaded into RAM. Any program that you run is also loaded into RAM. When you type some text on the computer, it is saved into RAM first. But when you shut down your computer, RAM gets cleared and everything in it gets erased. So RAM is the temporary memory. So after writing something in the computer, when we save it, so from the RAM it goes and stored into the ROM, which is the permanent memory. It's a start of instructions for the computer. It holds the instructions even when the power supply is switched off. So these instructions cannot be overwritten, but can only be read from the ROM. Now different types of RAM and ROM has come. Now we can erase also, we can rewrite also. Now next, we have given one difference between the RAM and the ROM, which is very, very important. So you just go through the difference. Next one is the different ports. This is also very, very important. This picture is given the backside of the CPU. If you notice, you can get these ports. So different color ports are given for different attachments. So ports in a computer system are used for providing interface for the external devices or the peripherals like the monitor, speakers, keyboard, mouse, etc. They are actually the part of the motherboard, and the external devices are plugged into these parts through the cables. So first is given the serial port. It's known as the communication port. A serial port can transmit one bit of data at a time. It can be used to connect devices like mouse, gaming, controllers, modems, and older printers. Next is the pink color parallel port. As the name suggests, this is used to send the multiple bits of data at once. It is mainly used to connect printers and other devices that need relatively high bandwidth. Next is the PS/2 port. It was developed by IBM and is used to connect mouse or keyboard to an IBM compatible computer. But nowadays, these ports are not in that much use because for mouse and keyboard, USB port has come. USB port is just like the pen drive we can insert. It's a standard cable connection for PCs and other electronic devices. USB connected devices cover a broad range from the keyboard to mouse, music player, pen drives, etc. It may also be used to send up power to some devices. So next it comes for the HDMI port. HDMI port is one of the audio or video interfaces which are used for transmitting the uncompressed video and digital audio data. Generally, it is used in the DVD player, Blu-ray player, cable boxes, etc. Next is the VGA port or video graphics array port. It's a standard type of connection used to connect video devices such as the monitors and projectors. It is mainly used to transfer analog video signals from one machine to another machine through the VGA cable. Next is comes for the modem. So modem is another important hardware part. A modem is a hardware device that connects a computer to a communication line, such as an internet cable. Modem stands for the modulator and demodulator. Modem can be of two types, external modem and the internal modem. An external modem is attached externally with the computer, while an internal modem is connected to the motherboard of the system inside the CPU box. So from the picture also, it's clear that how the data is transferred with the help of the modem. From the computer, it gets the digital signal. Digital signal is getting converted into analog and getting transferred through the telephone line. Again, through another modem, it is getting transferred to the digital signal. And from the digital signal, again, it is going to another computer. So picture is given. This is the external modem. Like this, only internal modems are also present. So this was the short descriptions of the internal hardware components. So next class, we will discuss the question answers. I hope you have understand the chapter. Three classes we have taken. So please once again you go through all these three classes, all these three PDFs and the explanations, and after that it will be easier for you to do the exercise. Thank you and bye.